Hi, I'm Nick Kamphuis. I'm a bass player from the Netherlands. I play for Maan, Ogeen, and all kinds of TV shows and events in the Netherlands. As a session bass player, I get into a lot of different situations and I need a lot of different bass tones. Like half a year ago, I started playing this GR bass set. It's a GR1800 head and two GR112H cabinets. I've been using this set because it's really versatile. I can use just the head as a bass DI when I'm playing in-ears. I can use the head and one cabinet when it's like small TV shows where there's like LED screens and cameras everywhere. Or I can use the full set when I really need volume in a like big event where there's no in-ears. I've been loving this set. In the next video, I want to show you a few tones that I get out of it. So enjoy. To get a cool slap sound, I've been using this 78 jazz bass. The jazz bass from the 70s have a bridge pickup that's a little closer to the bridge, which gives it a little bit more brightness, a little bit more spark to the high end. On the GR bass, I've been using a boost on the low and a little cut on the mid lows. This gives it this really compressed, scoopy low end. It sounds kind of like this. Okay, normally I would boost the high end on the amp a little bit more, but since it's such an old school sound, I've decided not to. But also this bass is really bright, and maybe with your bass, boosting the high end gives a little better result. So to get this kind of funky, growly bass tone, I've been using this Fender Jazz Bass. It's actually an 80s jazz bass from Fender Japan, but it has the 60s pickup spacing. So I've been mostly using the rear pickup, which gives this tight, growly sound. Sounds kind of like this. So it's really tight in the low end and also really gives you a mid-low presence. On the GR bass, I've been using the deep knob to kind of boost the low end, because sometimes you kind of miss the real low end when you're just playing the bridge pickup. I've been using the mid lows to really get this growl even more defined in the speakers. So when I don't use it, it sounds kind of like this. So basically your whole tone is in this mid low section of the EQ. The high mids is almost neutral. And the high end, I've been using just a little boost to give it a little bit more definition in the whole mix. For the previous track, I tried to get this really heavy indie rock bass tone. I've been using the Fender Precision Bass round wound strings, and I'm putting the volume and the tone knob wide open. I've been using the GR Bass Pure Drive, and the drive is pretty high up and the blend even higher to give it this really aggressive sound. It sounds like this. So the pedal really compresses the signal and really gives it a lot of bite in the high end. On the GR bass itself, I've been using it kind of flat with a little bump in the low mids to make it a little bit more easy to play. And the high mids really give it this pick bite tone you want. On the previous track, I tried to get this processed poppy bass sound, almost like a sampled bass guitar. I've been using my precision bass with round wound strings, and I've tuned it down to a low C sharp, which is like really low. I've been using a little bit of overdrive from the GR Bass Pure Drive, and without it, it would sound like this. And with it, it sounds like this. So it really gives like a nice bite to the pick sound. On the GR bass, I've been using like the deep knob and the bright knob. So it's even broader in the whole frequency spectrum. I've been using a big cut in the low mids and a big boost in the high mids. The low mids kind of take out this bass guitar sound, and the high mids really give it like the bite of the pick. In the previous track, I used this Fender Precision Bass to try and get this old school bluesy southern rock sound. I've been using flat wound strings on this one. I just cut the tone knob a little bit to make it a little less bright. I've been using mostly a neutral setting on the GR bass with a little boost on the low mids to get a little bit more presence in the mix. The GR bass really gives a transparent representation of how the precision bass sounds. For the previous track, I tried to get this really old school sound using this precision bass, the flat wound strings, and a little piece of foam to make the tone really dark and with even less sustain. So there's really no sustain at all, which I love. I've been using the settings on the GR bass like this, a little bit of low end, a little bit of low mid, and a little bit less high mids and highs to get this dark old school sound. Hi, thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed the video. I hope you enjoyed my playing and the bass tracks. And also that was kind of useful what I told about the bass amp, about the bass settings. I've been really happy with this GR bass set. And if you like it, maybe you should check it out too. Thanks.